the other day I told my mom I want to make a cooking video series, and she came up with the most brilliant name.
Why don't you make something simple, senang and sedap?
Like fun.
So welcome to the first episode of
Simple, Senang and Sedap.
In this first episode, we're gonna make kek batik. And this recipe, my mom actually learned it from our friend Zalifa. And it is so great.
Thank you, Zalifa.
It is chewy from the outside but crunchy from the inside.
Oh yeah, actually, yeah, true. So the ingredients you'll be needing are four things. One packet of Marie Biscuits, 300 grams of Milo, 250 grams of butter, and don't forget one can of condensed milk. Okay, over to you, Mom.
Hi, this is Auntie Nazura. Welcome to my kitchen. First, you have to weigh your ingredients, like 300 grams of Milo. And then the biscuit, you got to crack it. You crack it into four pieces.
What I like to do is I like to cut them in half and then cut them into another half, so I get four pieces.
But my style is I crack it in the middle. Sometimes you get it four.
But you know, just yeah, whatever floats
your boat. It's easier and faster. Nadira's method slightly slower.
Yeah.
First, turn on your stove on medium fire and melt the butter completely. Add in the condensed milk, a half can of condensed milk will do. And don't forget to stir. You stir it until you see the bubble. Then only you add in your Milo. And you stir and stir until it bubbles. Then you turn off the stove.
You don't want your Milo to burn.
Yeah.
That would be bad.
Lastly, add in the Marie biscuit.
And this part doesn't look that appetizing, but we're getting there.
Before that, you have to line your container with plastic sheet so it's easier for you to take it out later on, and also easier for you to clean up the container.
Then you have to pour in the whole mixture from the pot just now and then roll it with a rolling pin.
I have a few, big and small, but I don't know where's all my rolling pins. So in the end, I end up with my glass container. Just roll it on top of the kek batik just to compress it so that it looks nicer. So then it's done. Then leave
and
it
in the fridge
for at least half an hour. Usually, I've tried a few recipes before, but then the biscuit end up soggy.
But not this one. So yeah, just cut them into nice pieces and share them with your family and friends, because food is better when it is shared.
Have fun trying our simple, senang and sedap recipe. Bye-bye.
Bye guys. See you.